Dear students, in this module, we will talk about the World Population Plan of Action. This module helps us to get an understanding about the World Population Conferences that were held at the instance of the United Nations. Then the background for the World Population Plan of Action, the principles that were kept in mind while formulating the plan of action, the specific objectives of the population plan of action, and finally, the recommendations provided in the population plan of action. And then we will summarize. The United Nations organized international or world population conferences. In 1974, it was held at Bucharest. In 1984, it was held at Mexico City. And then in 1994, it was held at ICPD. ICPD conference 1994 was held at Cairo. The Bucharest conference was one of the three world conferences organized by the United Nations with specific focus on population. Let us now look at the Bucharest conference. Let me reiterate that it was held in 1974, and then in the conference, the international community highlighted common concerns regarding the emerging population issues, and the conference adopted the World Population Plan of Action. The plan of action basically contains recommendations and guidelines that are aimed at better quality of life and rapid socio-economic development for all the people. Development is the most important factor of the plan of action, around which several recommendations were evolving. The World Population Conference expressed due regard for human aspirations for a better quality of life and for rapid socio-economic development. And the conference also took into consideration the interrelationship between population situations and socio-economic development, and further decided on the World Population Plan of Action as a policy instrument within the broader context of internationally adopted strategies for national as well as international progress. Let us look at the background to the plan of action. Since 1950, the world population growth rates have risen to a considerable level, to 2% a year. It was felt that if this rate of growth was sustained, this would result in a doubling of world's population every 35 years. On the other hand, the national rates of natural growth of the population range widely. In some countries, it was negative. In some countries, it was well over 3% per year. Let us continue the discussion about the background to the plan. And considering the population problems cannot be reduced to analysis of population trends only, the present situation of developing countries originates in unequal processes of socio-economic development that have divided people since beginning of the modern era. Inequity exists, and it got intensified by lack of equity in international economic relations, having led to disparity in levels of living of people. Many developing countries considered reduction of mortality, particularly that of infant mortality, to be one of the most important and very crucial goals. Let us now turn to the primary aim of the plan. Guided by the principles, primary aim of this plan of action of 1974 World Population Conference held at Bucharest was to expand and deepen the capacities of countries to deal effectively with their national and subnational population problems and to promote an appropriate international response to their needs by enhancing international activity in research, the exchange of information, and provision of assistance on request. Let us now look at the specific objectives of the population plan of action. To advance understanding of population at global, regional, national, and subnational levels, recognizing the diversity of the problems involved. To continue the objectives, another objective was to advance national and international understanding of the interrelationship of demographic and socioeconomic factors in development. Then, to advance national as well as international understanding of the complex relations among the problems of population, resources, environment, and development, and to promote unified analytical approach to the study of these interrelationships and to the relevant policies. To promote the status of women and the expansion of their roles, their full participation in the formulation and implementation of socio-economic policy, including population policy, and creation of awareness among all women regarding their current and potential roles in national life. To recommend guidelines for population policies consistent with national values and goals and with internationally recognized principles. Another objective was to promote the development and implementation of population policies where necessary, including improvement in the communication of the purposes and goals of these policies to the public and promotion of popular participation in their formulation and implementation. Another objective relates to encouraging development and good management of appropriate education, training, statistical research, information and family health services, as well as statistical services in support of the above principles and objectives laid in the population plan of action document. Now, let us move towards the specific recommendations for action that were mentioned in the World Population Plan of Action, an outcome of the Bucharest Conference. These recommendations were pertaining to several components and aspects of population, such as population growth, population structure, fertility, family planning, migration, etc. Let us now look at the recommendations with respect to population growth. The recommendation says, countries which consider that their present or expected rates of population growth hamper their goals of promoting human welfare are invited, if they have not yet done so, to consider adopting population policies within the framework of socio-economic development that are consistent with basic human rights and national goals and values. So, this recommendation talks about the involvement of the governments at national level towards addressing the issues relating to population growth rate, and it also talks about the linkages between population growth, human rights, and national goals and values. The recommendation also mentions that countries that aim at achieving moderate or low population growth should try to achieve the same through a low level of birth and death rate. Countries desiring to increase their rate of population growth should, when mortality is high, concentrate efforts towards reduction of mortality and, where appropriate, encourage an increase in fertility and also encourage immigration. Another plan of action point for population growth was talking about recognizing that per capita use of world resources is much higher in the developed countries than in the developed countries. In view of this, the developed countries were urged to adopt appropriate policies in population, consumption, and investment, keeping in mind the need for fundamental improvement in international equity. Now, let us move to the recommendation relating to morbidity and mortality. The goal of this plan of action was to reduce mortality levels, particularly that of infant and maternal mortality, to the maximum extent possible in all regions of the world, and also to reduce national and subnational differentials in terms of mortality in various countries. The plan of action recommended that national and international efforts to reduce morbidity and mortality levels should be accompanied by vigorous efforts to achieve goals in terms of reduction of fatal infant and early childhood mortality and related maternal mortality as well as morbidity. Let us continue the discussion about recommendations relating to morbidity and mortality. The plan of action recommended that health and nutrition programs designed to address morbidity and mortality should be integrated within a comprehensive development strategy, and the same should be supplemented by a wide range of mutually supporting social policy measures. Special attention should also be given to improving the management of the existing health, nutrition, and related social services, and also towards formulation of policies so as to widen the coverage so that the programs reach in particular rural, remote, and underprivileged sections of the society. Now, let us move to fertility and family planning related recommendations of the plan of action. The governments that have family planning programs were invited to consider integrating and coordinating those services with health and other services aimed at raising the quality of family life. These include family allowances and maternal benefits, and also to consider including family planning services in their official health and social insurance systems. Because the couples have concerns regarding family planning, the policy should also be directed towards promotion of the psycho-social harmony and mental and physical well-being of the couples. Regarding fertility and family planning, the plan document also recommended that countries intending to have effective fertility levels reduction on priority basis should implement development programs and educational and health strategies, because these contribute to economic growth and higher standards of living, and also have a decisive impact on demographic trends including fertility. international cooperation is also called for, so as to give priority to assisting such national efforts, so as to ensure that these programs and strategies will be more effective. The recommendation relating to social justice talks about the promotion of social justice, social mobility and social development, particularly by means of a wide participation of the population in development and more equitable distribution of income, land, social services and amenities. It also talks about promotion of wide educational opportunities for the youth irrespective of sex, and extension of public forms for school education for the rising generations, the elimination of child labor and child abuse, and establishment of social security and old age benefits were also talked about. Now let us move to age at marriage. Establishment of an appropriate lower limit for age at marriage was made mention of, and the plan document recommended that governments should consider making provision in both their formal and non-formal educational programs for informing their people about the consequences of existing or alternative fertility behavior for the well-being of the family, for educational and psychological development of children, and for the general welfare of the society, so that an informed and responsible attitude to marriage and reproductive will be promoted among the couples. Family size may also be affected by incentives and disincentive schemes. The plan document says that family size may also be affected by incentive and disincentive schemes. However, the document says that if such schemes are adopted or modified, it is essential that they should not violate human rights. Preserving human rights was given importance in this recommendation. Some social welfare programs such as family allowances and maternity benefits may have a positive impact on fertility and may thus be strengthened when such an effect is desired. However, such programs should not in principle be calculated or however such programs should not be curtailed if the opposite effect on fertility is desired. Moving to the fertility related recommendations, countries that desire to reduce their birth rates were invited to give particular consideration to the reduction of fertility at the extremes of females reproductive ages because of the effects that may have on infant and maternal welfare. The document also says that family is recognized as the basic unit of society and asks the governments to assist families as far as possible. In continuation to the earlier discussion, the family be protected by appropriate legislation and policy without discrimination, and family ties be strengthened by giving recognition to the importance of love and mutual respect within the family unit. As regards the status of women, government should make a sustained effort to ensure that legislations regarding status of women comply with the principles spelt out in the declaration on the elimination of discrimination against women and other United Nations declarations, conventions and international instruments, so as to reduce the gap between law and practice through effective implementation, and to inform women at all socioeconomic levels about their legal rights and responsibilities. As regards internal migration, internal migration policies should include provision of information to the rural population concerning economic and social conditions in the urban areas, including information on availability of employment opportunities. When we move to the recommendations relating to international migration, the recommendation says that governments and international organizations generally facilitate voluntary international movement. However, the document says that such movements should not be based on racial considerations, which are to be deterrent of which would affect the indigenous populations. Significance of international migration varies widely among countries, and it depends on their area, population size and growth rate, besides socio-economic structure and environmental situation. The governments which consider international migration to be important to their countries, either in the short run or in the long run, were urged to conduct an appropriate bilateral or multilateral consultations on the basis of the principles laid out by the United Nations. And it also recommended that international organizations should make available, upon request, coordinate technical and financial assistance to facilitate the settlement of people in countries of immigration. And it also talks about the problems relating to refugees and displaced persons. And then the recommendation also talks about assistance and encouragement to be provided to the workers and our returning workers. And it also talks about the cooperation at bilateral level or through regional organizations and international community. As regards the population structure, the governments were asked to formulate development policies and programs taking into account the implications of changing population structure. And specifically, the developing countries were urged to consider the implications of population structure and changes in the population structure with specific reference to the young population. And developing countries were also invited to consider the economic and social demographic effects of population shift from agriculture to non-agriculture industries. Let us now move to data collection and analysis. The plan document gives emphasis to the statistical data on population that is collected through census, surveys and vital statistics registers, and talks about the importance of this data. And then it urges the governments to pay attention to the data collection and analysis part. And it also encouraged the governments to establish continuing capability for taking household sample surveys on long term basis. Coming to the research, the plan of action gives high priority to research activities on various issues relating to population and population problems. And it also talks about collection, analysis and dissemination of information. And the recommendation also talks about assessment and improvement of existing and new methods relating to fertility regulation through research. It also talks about the research to be carried out on various issues relating to population policy. Now, having discussed about the World Population Plan of Action, let us just summarize what all we have discussed so far in this module. Through this module, we got a fair understanding about the background of the conference, the Bucharest conference, and the principles of population plan of action. We looked at the objectives of the population plan of action. Then specifically we looked at the recommendations laid out in the population plan of action document in terms of population structure and growth, family, age at marriage, status of women, social justice, fertility and family planning, migration, mortality and morbidity, data collection, analysis and research. As a result of the discussion we had in this module, we got fair understanding about the issues that were raised in the population plan of action document as an outcome of the World Population Conference held in Bucharest in 1974, and the various issues relating to population, development, human rights, status of women, well-being of women and children, role of family, etc. And we also got an understanding about the policy directions and policy recommendations that were provided by the conference through its plan of action for population for the respective governments, so that they can initiate action towards well-being of all the people, including development of all sections of the society, being an important objective of the respective countries. Thank you so much.